Well, Missy, congratulations, first of all. I mean, you're just breaking barriers all over the place, and you're amazing in this movie. Disney Christmas movie. I mean, what a dream.
It's a dream.
Does it feel amazing?
Yes. Yeah. And every time I see it, I still, like, I see something different, but I get just as excited. You know, I think to be able to share this story that means so much to the ballet world and so much to me, you know, having the Nutcracker was my first, the first ballet I ever performed in, eight months after I started dancing when I was 13. And, you know, and most dancers perform the Nutcracker every single year. So it's a part of our holiday tradition. And so it means so much to have incorporated ballet in this Disney version.
Well, ballet always to me looks incredibly difficult, which I know it is, but for a movie, like, it's take after take, I'm assuming, like a normal film. So I'm thinking this is probably even harder. Is it? Like, or is it easier?
It's just different.
Okay.
As dancers, you know, at American Ballet Theatre, where I'm a principal dancer, we start our mornings at 10:30 or 10:15 a.m. and we work until 7 p.m. So we're in the studio training for up to 8 hours a day, and sometimes with no break in between. And even if we do 5 hour days, we still put on a 3 hour performance in the evening. So we're used to the long hours. I think it's just getting used to, like, a different type of pacing yourself. But I only had 7 days to learn how to pace myself when filming this film.
Oh, really?
So it was pretty exhausting in every way. Yeah. I don't often ice my feet at this point, and I did every night. When I was filming this.
Oh my God. you must be a very determined person, because obviously the first African-American female to the American Ballet Theatre to be principal. Did you always know it would happen? Because something like that has never happened before. So that's a different type of determination, I think, to have, to be going for something and going, yes, it will happen, even though it's never happened before. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean?
Yes, I definitely had my ups and downs of, you know, as a young girl, I just loved ballet. And so it wasn't like none of that was in the back of my mind, like being African American, or there wasn't a first. Like, I didn't even know any of that, because our history as Black people is not often told in the ballet world. So it was all new. Yeah. But once I became a professional and I started hearing, you're the only Black girl, I was the only Black woman in American Ballet Theatre for over 10 years. And so when you start having all of those things that kind of build up, you're like, maybe it isn't possible. So I definitely had my ups and downs, and it wasn't until I had amazing support in my life that allowed me to think, like, it's okay that it's never been done. Yeah. It's okay to be different. Like, anything can happen if you have the right drive and will and focus and support.
Okay.
And now, I feel like that's who Clara is in the film. It's such a very similar experience, I think, to who I am and how I've experienced my life. And, you know, for her, she's so strong-willed, especially as a young woman, and she did it all on her own, of course, with support, but.
Yeah, and so many people look up to you now, little girls, little boys, everybody looks up to you. But as a kid, I think you'd be surprised, we share an icon, I believe. I was surprised myself. Mariah Carey.
I knew it.
Growing up, loved her. Like, but was she, are you, is this true, or is this one of these things?
It's like beyond true. It's embarrassing.
It's
a little too much stuff that's connected to why I love her.
Right.
I mean, you know, it's deeper than I think I realized at the time when I was a young girl. I think, you know, her first album came out the same year that my sixth child, my youngest brother, was born. And it was also a year that was extremely difficult for me as a young girl. You know, I was going through a lot. My mom, I think, had married her fifth husband. And, you know, there was a lot of stuff going on. I felt like she was kind of the savior that came into my life at different times when I needed a voice or someone to connect to. And I think also being a biracial woman, I connected in that way, in a subconscious way. I don't think I realized. And seeing someone that was powerful and talented and succeeding, and I feel like, you know, I know that I am that to so many people. So it's just, it's so important to have representation, and to be a Black ballerina in this Disney Nutcracker film, it's incredible for people to see, no matter what race they are, what gender, that it doesn't matter if you don't fit in this mold that society has told us you have to be. Anything's possible.
So true. Thank you so much. Congratulations, Misty.
Thanks. Brilliant. FM 104, Dublin's hit music station.